Hi, this is Amber Graphic Design How-To, and today we're going to be working with type in Adobe Illustrator. We are going to also talk about type manipulation and how to use OpenType features, which are available in some fonts, but not all fonts. So OpenType fonts are a little different than OpenType font features. Not every OpenType font will have the features. So that's something to note. Another thing we'll go over today is how to kind of make a font look a little more hand-drawn for that hand-drawn signature effect. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, this is a signature font. It's kind of like a handwriting script, and I got it for free online, Signatura Monoline, and that link is in the comments section. First, let's open the OpenType palette. So go to Type, Window, Type, and OpenType. All right, and I'm going to put this up into my character palette, where it goes. As you can see, we have a couple options here. You can click through them to see the different types of characters under each style. You can also just highlight one specific character and then change just that one. I think I like that one because I don't like how it crosses the P. Now let's try the P. Yeah, maybe I'll do something with that later. Whenever you're working with fonts and you want them to look handwritten, you shouldn't leave two characters right beside each other that look the same. So we want one of these to be a little bit different. Let's see if we can. Okay, not a lot there. So I'll probably just leave it like this and we'll change it in a minute. I can show you how to do that once you've outlined the font. And let's look at this S, which doesn't look like an S to me. That's better. Before I outline this font, I want to modify it so it looks as good as possible before being outlined. So I'm going to Option, click between the T and the Y, and then Option, Arrow, and move that in. That looks a lot better. And maybe we'll move this S up. You can do that in the character palette right here. That's baseline shift, and you can just use your arrows to see how it's going to turn out. Now maybe about there. And then we'll also move the spacing between the S and the E in a little more. There we go. Okay, so I think we're pretty close here. I'll go ahead and make a copy. Whenever you're working with type, you also want to make a copy so you can have a live type path there in case you need to change the word later. And then we'll come down here and hit Shift Command O. That will outline it. So at this point, we can start really manipulating things to look really hand lettered so that it doesn't look so samey-same all over the place. Okay, with your group selection tool, just move things how you want them. I would like to connect these two. Maybe I can do that now. I'm going to deselect. And then with my end tool, I'll just draw this like this. I'm going to zoom in with my Z tool and we'll give this a little black outline. And I'll bump it up to about the same, well, maybe 3.5. Okay, that looks good. So let's expand that. This. Shift Command E and then Command E. Okay, and that works. Now hit Shift E for your eraser tool and we'll get rid of this little bit right here. Now it looks like it's erasing the E, but it's actually not. It's only erasing what I have selected. If that E was part of the selection, it would erase that. So be mindful of that. Now we'll hide this with Command 3 and I want to delete this. If you have no selection, you can just delete it and it will delete. Okay. So let's unhide Option Command 3 and let's zoom out and see how that looks. All right, I like that. I kind of want to get a little curve here for a connection here. So I'll do that with my End tool again. Just go over it like this. And now it is 3.5, I remember that from last time. And that looks pretty good. I'll get rid of this little piece here with Shift E to erase it. All right, pretty close now. And now I'll grab my A tool, click right on that line, and then maybe just connect it. All right, move this one over. Now something's going on here, so I want to get rid of that. Shift E to fix that. And let's see, my T's are being a little weird. Maybe I can just have one long swash across the T's. Let's see if these are connected. I'm going to hit G to get to my group selection tool. You can get to that under here. I have this set up as a special key command for myself. It's usually gradient, so you can either set that up or just click on it. Okay, they are not separate. So I'm going to go ahead and use my end tool to cut off this line. So you have to start exactly on the line and end up exactly on the line going the same direction. The same here, start on the line and end up going the same direction. Okay, now let's just go ahead. What can I do here? I think I'll use my Q tool to draw around this and then Command X to cut it, and we'll paste in front. Same over here, Q tool, Command X, and paste in front. Now I'm going to hit Command J and that should join it, and you can see here that it's been joined here. And I will also select this piece and join that, Command J. And now we can just grab this and keep it with the Pathfinder, unite those two. We'll use the Command S for smooth. That's right underneath your pencil tool. I also, that's a special key command that I have set up. So let's smooth that out. All right, that's better. Now let's hide that, Command 3. And I'm going to Command Y so you can see a little more what's going on here. I'm going to take this piece of my A tool and this dot and connect them with Command J. And same here, Command J. Now, I'm going to smooth that with Shift S or the Smooth tool underneath your Pencil tool. And we'll zoom out and see how we look. All right, we're getting there. So now I've got just this piece. I unhid that with Option Command 3. And now I'm just going to stretch it. So we'll grab a corner here. And that looks pretty good. I'm liking that a lot. I think the Y is a little bit boring. I think it needs to start up a little higher. So let's go in there, zoom in with your Z. Highlight just the points that you want with your A tool. You have to get right on the edge and right on a point and then just drag it up. And same here, we'll just get right on a point and drag it up. And then I'll smooth this out with Shift S. Whoa, that didn't work quite the way I wanted, so I'll just back up. We'll just do this manually. All right. Let's zoom out, Command minus. And I know I got rid of that feature before, but I'm going to go ahead and add in a little swatch that goes like this. So I'll do that with my end tool. So I'm going to start up here just to get the feeling of it a little better. And we'll go like this. All right, now we want to put that at 3.5. And it's kind of rough. It all depends on what your smooth settings are underneath your pencil tool. So you can put your smoothness up. I usually like to keep it about here. That's why it became so rough. But now let's hit Shift S to smooth it out. You just go over the parts of it. And the tip of all these others are round. So I'm going to go ahead and round the tip of the stroke by hitting the two middle things on the cap and the corner. And as you can see, it's rounded now. Okay, let's lock that with Command 2. And now I'm going to highlight the Y and I'm going to delete that piece. Shift E to remove it. Okay. Let's see how that looks. We'll Command minus. Okay, I think this is starting to really look like an actually handwritten thing. Another thing we want to do is probably change the height of one of these so it doesn't look so samey-samey. Maybe more like that. And we can smooth this one out but leave the other one. That way they look a little bit different. Oops. Let's get that back out there. Nice, smooth. Okay, and I think we are pretty much done. The spacing here is a little big, so let's move that in too. And move it about right there, maybe with the N also. All right. For this, I'm just going to grab the edge of this, and you have to get right on the very edge with your G plus tool, and that's your group selection tool. And then I'll just slightly do that. And same here, I don't think I'm going to squeeze this one. I'll just redraw it. So I'm starting on the path exactly with my pencil tool. I'm going to come up here and then go back down, and you have to end up right the same way you were going on that path. And that's a little tricky. It's kind of hard to get used to, but I think you'll find with practice it gets a lot easier. So just like with anything. Okay, let me smooth this out. And, oh, what happened to our G? Okay, now this is something that might happen if you accidentally, you forget to grab the center part, and you can fix that by going to Command Y, using your group selection to click right on that and just move it back over. Yeah, maybe, okay. And it looks like we're done. Okay, so if you like this video, please click the like button. If you have any questions or comments, or if something's not working for you the way you like it, please feel free to comment in the comment section below, and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. Thank you, guys.